Hello everyone, this is Cipher Deck, and we are back in Kingdom Come Deliverance, and we're heading for the Bandit Camp. And we're going to try to scout it out and see what they're up to. What are their malicious, what is their malicious intent? So, while we're going there, I had some things I wanted to talk to you about, or a thing that I wanted to talk to you about, and just talk to you about it. So I was looking at the WarHorse Studio's YouTube channel, and they show videos of any updates that they have. And I saw a video that they actually added alchemy into the game. So we don't just have the skill, we can actually do alchemy. You have to find the alchemy lab through a quest, and then at that point you can start doing alchemy. So the thing that they said was that instead of just doing alchemy where you collect the items that you have or that you need and just combine them and just get something out of it, of course a game that goes into this much detail over swordplay is going to not just make it easy for you. So apparently you have a mini game that you have to play, which I liked it already whenever they said that. You have to put water in a cauldron, heat the cauldron until it is boiling or steeping or steaming, whatever you want to call it, and then you add your ingredients, and you have to wait a certain amount of time before you add each ingredient, and then finally when you are done, you pour it into a vial and you find out if you did it correctly. So that is amazing. So I'm thinking you can make poisons and potions, antidotes, and all kinds of things that would allow you to be able to help people around you, hurt people around you, and maybe even help yourself. But then I started thinking, if they're going to do that with alchemy, what are they going to do with blacksmithing? Are they going to add other crafting, like fletching, to make better bows? Are they going to add armor smithing so you can make better armor? Because I would love it that as we progress as a character, we are able to create bigger and better armor. So we start out as a poplar? Is that how it's actually said? Someone who is of not very well off, poplar, or is that just a tree type? Peddler? No. Anyway, cobbler? I don't know what it is. Anyway, if you could start in dire straits as far as your equipment goes, and as you grow and get skill, you're able to create, chain armor, then lamellar armor, well that's tailoring, but be able to create, just trying to think, then you can create full plate, you can make your own helmet type that matches your attitude, I guess, and you can make your own sword. What kind of swords can you make? Or can you make sabers? Can you make scimitars? Can you, and then you think, well, what if you can make Damascus steel? What if you can make layered steel? And those are the kind of things that me as a fan of blacksmithing, not that I've ever done blacksmithing in my life, that's what that actually makes me wonder, because I have done a lot of research into blacksmithing and what it takes or what you do exactly with the metal. And so anyway, that's the kind of things I'm thinking for crafting and what they're doing with it exactly. So anyway, let's take a look here. We got this riggedy, rackety old bridge. I don't think that Rubard would want us to bring an army across it.
Take a while to get across, and there's nowhere to hide from arrows.
Agreed, because even if you could do two or three man wide, oh come on, you will end up coming down to this point and you're going to be funneling one man at a time out of that forest. That is no dice. Alright, I'm seeing stuff here, but I don't want to get caught. Let's make a swift move over here and sneak. Oh, just figured something out. shift. Oh, can you not go up this whenever you're going slow? Okay, there we go. I thought I saw mushrooms. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. Bandits. Those are bandits, it looks like. 7. There's that church Timmy was talking about. Oh, am I setting up now? Let's go ahead and bring that up.
A stockade. A handful of men could hold it for quite a while.
Why are you standing up? Let's go this way. Make no noise. Shh. I don't see anyone. Don't see me. Don't see me. Looking across. There's a guy there. Try to stay really close to this.
Good ground for a big fight, but not much cover.
Okay. Is there anyone down there? That's what I want to know. I don't know why I'm talking silently. I'm scared. Don't want to get caught. There's a road down there. Just follow along here a little bit. Oh boy. We're out in daylight, man.
They can see far and wide from that steeple and those arches up there. That will be a problem.
Just going nice and slow. Don't want anyone to see me. There's a guy right there. Alright, let's back up. Let's back up. Let's watch him for a minute. See if anyone comes to relieve him. See if how many guys are part of that right there. I know it's probably going to be boring, but I do not want to get caught. Okay, so we're looking at a bridge there. And then we have what looks like this actually leads. If we would have kept going straight across, we would have came out here. This is where the bandit opening was, and it looks like someone would probably roam here. And then it goes up this way. I think we could probably go, if we can get across that bridge, we could probably go along here and come over here. Or we can go, we can backtrack and go this way and be able to go up here. Because this looks like another path. And if it's a flat path, it may actually be the best way to go. So, Alright. Well, let's take a look. I haven't seen any relief for him yet. Of course, I don't know if it stops timer. Can I go across? Nope, I can't go any further. There he is. Sounds like he's talking to somebody.
Yeah,
Is he talking to himself, or is there two people there, and they're stacked on top of each other? Come on. If I stand up right now, it's going to show exactly where I am. Can I go see if there's anyone at this camp over here? I guess. Because I can't really do anything else over there. Sorry if it looks like I'm going crazy and... It doesn't look like I can go past that way. It looks like it's pushed me out to the open. Nobody's here. I could probably come back across. Yeah, I don't want to pick metal right now. I have a guy right over there, and I don't want to go very fast. But it looks like I can't make it up this hill if I don't. You know what I'm gonna do, if it'll let me. It doesn't see me yet. Really? I can't make it up this little hill? Those rocks? Oh, he's gonna see me for sure. I'm so freaking close. He still has his weapon down. I can't tell if anyone else is coming. I mean, he's not even looking at me, man. I don't see anyone coming. If I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna have to be quick. Is that two people? Thought I just saw a shield shift. This is gonna be bad if it is. Oh, get up, get up. Oh, you're going exactly where I want you to die. Good day, my friends. Good day. Alright. I think we're done with there. I think we got everything we needed. I'm not even going to go up to the top. To be honest, I think that's going to be a waste. I think we got all the information we really needed. My horse is going to come up behind me right here, and I think we're going to go ahead and head to Robard. I also think it's probably going to be around 2 o'clock, and we want to get to him before nightfall. We also need rest. We need food. And so we're going to stop in Talmberg to get it. So let's get this done with. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hugging the right a little bit. There we go. Or left, I mean. And we're looking for a flat rock. Oh, there it is. And we go this way. I probably don't want to be going through this really fast, but I'm... Oh, yeah. Hello. Oh, yeah. Alright, so we've learned that there are several ways that we can enter the fort. A lot of them are very scary and will probably cause us our death. If you take the amount of people that we did see, I would say multiply them by 5, and that will give us close to 50 people that are in that camp. Maybe 40, but 50 sounds like it would be more correct, just by the fact that there are just so many of them. We're able to get through and at least get a lot of information about the town or about the place. We saw flat ground that would be good for a battle, but it still is probably not the best route. There was that section that he said that there was a way we could sneak and take them by surprise. So I think that's probably going to be the best way, and I don't even know how this conversation is going to go. I don't know if he's going to allow me to lead him or if he's going to lead the conversation, but we'll see how it goes. So this is going to be it. We're getting down to the nitty-gritty. We're going to go to where Rubard is. We're going to give him the news, and at that point he is going to tell us what we do next. And I believe what we do next is either kill or be killed. And it's going to probably be based off the information that I got while I was there. Just looking at the sun, and just looks so nice. Plus, my mouse likes to pull forward for some reason, and I have more than ample room for it. So I don't know. Anyway, let's go ahead and cut down here. And let's get a little bit of moving ahead up here. Hello, good sir. Okay, let's see what we have and see what we need to get rid of. Actually, yeah, I think that's best. Oh, you can have all my rotten food. Thank you for taking that from me. It's definitely more your taste than mine. Actually, he's paying me for it. Can't believe he's paying me for it. He's a gullible. Repair my stuff. That doesn't work. Okay, let's go ahead and buy. So I don't think I'm going to use any. I wouldn't use any of these swords. I mean, if this was a piercing weapon, maybe. I mean, it probably isn't going to do very much. Yeah, you can see the attack is it pierces for 4, but the slash is only 2 and the blunt is 2. This is 3, 3, 2, and mine is, well, 5, 4, 5. So that is the best weapon. Alright, how many arrows do I have? I have 43 freaking arrows. That's insane. Alright, he has stuff. And, I'm gonna buy about 20 bandages. And we're going to buy about 20 apples. Now, the reason we're buying so many is because we can put them on our horse. Well, how much did they say they were? Let's go rich. Okay, and we will go ahead and I think that's everything that we need. Let's go ahead and go to our basket, and we'll go ahead and just press X. I think we don't really need to worry about all of that, but we do need to eat some of the food that we got, and then we need to put the rest on my horse. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and put the rest on the horse. Now, the reason I'm doing that is because the horse is like a dead body. That's not the way I meant it. A horse is, well, it is like a dead body. If you kill someone and they have food on them, it's 100%. And whenever you go back to that body, say 2 or 3 minutes later, because you need that food now, it's still at 100%. So if you put your food and stuff on your horse, it's like putting it in storage, and it tends to survive longer. My horse is a corpse. And then you see him catch on fire. Yeah. That's not medieval. But anyway, yeah, he allows you to be able to store food items, and it will not decay those items. Okay, so I cannot run fast anymore because he has too much on him. That weighs 17 weight. Oh my goodness. Yeah. I didn't expect it to weigh that much. I have 2 gloves on me. I have okay. You know, whenever you go into the woods and you're going to the bathroom, well, that's what I'm about to do with some of this loot from my horse. So let's go ahead and get rid of that. Get rid of that. Both of them. Get rid of that. I think I just hit X, like, lightly. Let's get rid of that and get rid of that. Now if we go to our character, I think... I put... What was it that I said that I wanted to keep? I can't remember. But now we can actually look and see what it is that I put on him. Yeah, I liked this. Because it increases my speech. So I'm going to put that on my horse for right now, which is already dying of weight. And see if by getting rid of... Oh, yeah. Back to normal. Oh, yeah. he can't take wide turns, or he can't take quick turns whenever he's going fast. Or maybe it's just the person riding him. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get to Robard's camp. And then we are going to rest for the night. And at that point, the next day, next time we talk, we will be ready for the battle of our lives. Yeah. let's see. Let's go across this way. I wonder if they plan to at some point allowing us to put hoof marks in the dirt. Maybe that's like future way along the way. Don't think that's actually going to be possible. But, you never know. I mean, they were able to do that with mods for Skyrim, but that's asking a lot, I think. That, I definitely don't want to see. I think it's interesting if you're looking to the side, because it would probably slide a little bit. But you couldn't see your actual head. You can't actually do this. What? It's not how it works in real life. Alright, so we're here. I'm going to go ahead and get some rest. And we will talk next time. This is it. This is The last thing that we're going to be doing, and maybe we will, this is the last time we're going to be seeing these men before they go into battle. Maybe they're going to die tomorrow. You never know. But they're eating their last meals, and hopefully they will be coming home to their families sometime. This is Cipher Deck. Peace out.